eyes. It's past 1 a.m. and your baby girl is shooting a video. And no, I'm not going to say anything. Who is not happy about today's Friday X party? No, let's gather here and talk. Who is not happy about it? Because me, I'm not happy. Where is our ex? Where is our crush? You get? Where are they now? I was just seriously waiting today. Auntie, do what only you can do. Auntie, do your worst today. Finish us. Kill us. Only for us to be waiting. The first hour passed. The second hour passed. I did not see crush. I did not see ex. They were going inside. I said, okay, oh, let me still be waiting. Just in case anything will still happen. I waited. I waited. My people, nothing happened. Ex did not show up and crush did not show up. Man, I'm heartbroken. No, auntie, no. I don't know why I'm being dramatic about this, but please just let me know below if you were not happy about the fact that there was no ex or anything. Yeah, I understand that the show is becoming predictable and auntie is looking for every possible means to make sure that people do not predict this show. And I know that she's also knowing somewhere in her heart that the fans or the viewers are already knowing that there may likely be two nomination or double nomination, eviction or checkout. So she may also do a plot twist on Sunday. But before we talk about Sunday, let's talk about today being the Friday X party. So the party was just really lit today. The DJ was giving us some old school vibe and everybody was on fire, of course, except our dearly beloved Obi. But today Abby was, yeah, she was up there all around dancing. They're giving some choreography, some steps, some moves. But no, that's not why I'm here. Let's just leave that. Let's leave the party now. But thank God though, there was child drama. You will know the Friday night drama that always happens after the party. This time, the whole house was upside down. Chidi and Sylvia had problem, which is the trivia. They had their own issues. OBAB had issues with Theresa. Then Rosie had issue with Bolale. Bolale had issue with Arnold. Arnold had issue with Bolale. As in, everything was just, there was just a mix up in the house. And what happened, guys? The thing that happened is, oh, somebody took somebody's alcohol. Who took this alcohol? This alcohol is not yours. This alcohol is mine. Apparently, Bolale said she took out one bottle of alcohol, a white wine, I think, to go and keep aside for she and Arnold for later. So, Rosie started looking for her own alcohol, and she said, Abby came and met her. Please, if you know this gist, correct me if I'm wrong, because the mix-up is just somehow. The bottom line is that Bolale had kept it aside, she had given it to Abby to keep. But now, Abby and Obi were aware about this whole plan, but then people were looking for alcohol, so she couldn't really say that, oh, this alcohol belongs to Bolale, because she doesn't want people to know that she's keeping this alcohol for the surprise that she wanted to do for Arnold later. So Obi now had to go and meet Theresa and meet Rosie as well to say, see, oh, this wine is for Bolale. So Theresa, I don't understand, but she was just really upset. In fact, she started saying things like, then they mad. I will give it to them hot. I don't even know anything they happen. I say, when all these ones happen, what is really going on that is causing them they mad and then they crazy and when all this one happen kind of thing. I believe that the whole energy of you nominated me and you did not nominate me is still somewhere around the air, surrounding Abby and Theresa. But then I don't see why this whole you drank my alcohol, you did not drink my alcohol, who took the white one, who did not take the white one, will now cause this kind of heat in the house. So but Bolale was trying to make everybody understand that, see, this alcohol belongs to this, who took this one, there was one under the table, I kept this one, I went to meet Kachi. Rosie was explaining that she went to meet Kachi and told Kachi that she was keeping this wine for she and the girls, that the other time it was him and the boys, so she's keeping this wine. Now Bolale is saying this other wine is this wine. Guys, please, let me know, because I'm confused here. Leave your comments below. Then for Chivia, Sylvia was just really upset about the fact that Chidi was all over the place. Like, after the party, they entered the house, he was so loud, he was shouting, he was begging Rosie for suya, Rosie was running, you know. So Sylvia started saying, Chidi, stop it, it's okay. And the thing caused some kind of sharp misunderstanding between them. And if you know, they've given them the love nest already, Presh. David left the love nest to Chivia. So they got into the love nest and they kept talking back and forth that, oh, so Chidi was like, are you trying to say that I cannot be myself? Have I ever come to the house to shout and be this loud? So this one time that I'm trying to be loud, why are you taking it personal? Why don't you just let me be? She was not like, it's getting too much, it's getting out of hand. I don't want people to think that you are high or you're tipsy. That was how I was trying to stop you. He now said, even if I was high or tipsy, what is wrong with, oh, we had a party, I had drinks, and if I'm tipsy, what is wrong with it? She's not like, see, I'm not trying to stop you. He said, no, because she also does things that he feels like is not comfortable. He doesn't stop her. That this one time that he's doing this thing, that he doesn't do it all the time. Why didn't she just let him? So she was saying, see, if I do something wrong and I'm getting overboard with it, talk to me, call me to order, and I will listen to you. And that is simply what I was trying to do. Sha went back and forth, talked about it, and Sha settled. And that was it. You know, now our Chibia vibes, they know the verse, they know the quarrel, they know the carry quarrel, enter the next day. So Rosie now too, she was explaining to Theresa, explaining to Bolanle. She was not even saying, Bolanle, you are the cause of all these things. She now went to Miss Kachi, explaining to Kachi that, baby, Chibi, I told you that this wine, I'm keeping it for me and the girls. I don't understand why this wine is not costing issues in the house. Kachi just kept quiet, listened to her, said, okay, just calm down, just let it slide, it's okay, don't make a fuss out of it. See, some people are tipsy today, some people are drunk, just let everything slide, okay? She now said, okay, baby, it's all there. And I started doing all the things that they know how to do, but Sha kissed and Sha now started laughing about it. Then OBAB, you know that Theresa, she's everywhere, and I have been talking to Theresa, baby, calm down, let it go, there's no need to talk about this, it's okay. Because Theresa kept shouting, I don't even drink alcohol today, the only thing I drank was Schweppes. I don't see any reason why anybody will come and be talking to me about alcohol. I'm not with anybody's alcohol. Anybody that wants to this should this. I don't even care. Are they mad? You know, she was talking. I was talking to her, babe, calm down. She shall make sure that she finished ranting and all that. She now calmed down. Chidi, the counselor, the advisor guy, came, spoke to her, told her that, see, you people, you know that your love is sweet in this house. You know that you people are like a super couple. So you don't expect everybody to be happy about it. The time is darn near where only like 4 couples will be left till the final. So a lot of things are happening. People are playing games. So just leave everything, anyhow you see it. Just try and bottle it up and just forget about it. Live freely with everybody. So after talking to Chidi, she now went to be with Ike as they were there. OBAB, who are the people that she felt had issues with her, Obi came, spoke to her, explained that, oh, there's no issue here. What statement did they make that made you feel this way? Oh, okay, we're not going to make this kind of statement again. Can we settle now? So that's how they said, oh, we don't have any issues. Obi extended the handshake to Theresa. They shook hands, and here he left. Then the next couple that had issue was Double Chris. Everybody will know how Chrisville is during the party. He's always jumping everywhere, but Chrisville is a vibe, though, giving us some crazy dance moves and of course jumping and scattering the place. I don't know if he's tipsy or if he gets tipsy every Friday, but he danced with Chris, of course, after the whole party, and they went inside. He now started trying to get all touchy feeling with Chris, holding her, pecking her, kissing her. She was like, babe, hold on, slow down, you are high, I think you are tipsy, calm down. It's not like, even if he's tipsy, Shay, he knows what he's doing, he knows his boundaries. So what would he possibly do to her that she's doing, oh, calm down, hold on? So he now said, okay, it's okay, no problem. He now pecked her and Shay wanted to go. She now said, are you leaving? He said, yes, now I'm going. He said, no, I want you to stay. The Shay did their love, mushy mushy, stayed for a while, and yeah, that was how they settled. The next people that had issue in the house, in fact, we'll just notice that Fresh David was somehow not in the picture as all these things are going on. Like, they were just on the low. I don't know what's going on with them, but there's little or nothing to say about them, because during the party, Sha, they were dancing, yeah, but after the whole party, when everybody was having their saga, Fresh David was Sha doing their thing separately, moving up and down, no issue, no gist, they are Sha just there. Then the next couple that had issue is Bolanle and Arnold. Something happened before the party. Bolanle was telling Arnold to go and take his bath. Even Rosie was telling Kachito that they should go and take their bath, you know, pressuring them at all. So they took an offense with it that why are they kids? After the party, Arnold went to tell Bolali that, am I a child? Why were you just telling me go and take your bath? You were just speaking to me somehow. And he was not expecting Bolali to apologize. Bolali did not apologize. So he was upset and then he left. But then before the night is over, like I said, this is like 1 a.m. They ate together. They've settled now. And yeah. So guys, I would like to know what happened. This party, how do you feel about the fact that there was no ex and there was no crush? You know, this ex thing that brings this jealousy, this insecurity, and this crush thing. I really like that feel. Yeah, I like the atmosphere that it brings. So how do you feel about it? Was it good that auntie did not bring ex or crush for you? Do you think that it's okay to have this plot twist? And then what do you think about the whole saga that happened in the house? Please comment below. Do you think that Rosie was being overly concerned and just thinking, because she was like, why am I in the middle of this? Do you think that Rosie was going too far? Do you also think that Theresa was going too far? And what do you think about AB's reaction? Because AB was just like, oh, I would have this, I would have done that, I don't like getting myself in this, let us just be in this house, I don't even care if God says we should be. AB, she knows how to spiritualize things. AB of the Most High God. She's like, if God says we'll stay here, we'll stay here, there's nothing anybody can do. I say, auntie, has it reached like that? So guys, I would like to know your thoughts on this. I said, let me come and shoot this video before I'll just, because at some point I said, I think I should just go and sleep, because nothing really happened today for me to come and talk. Really, nothing really happened. But then I'm like, let me come and talk to you people, yeah? Let us gist on the comment section. So anything that I missed here, you can just, you know, gist me. Let's talk below. Okay, I've come to the end of today's video. If there's anything I'm missing, really, I'd like you to tell me, yeah? Because it's 1 a.m. and my head, I cannot really think right now. And I'm not holding a book. So, yeah, I'm going to see you on the next one. Until next time, guys. Bye!